Later in the day today, Netanyahu said that he has not made a decision on whether to attack Iran. In the past, Israel has destroyed nuclear facilities in Syria and Iraq, but Iran is very different, and we asked David Martin to show us.
Iran can't build a nuclear weapon without the massive complexes of centrifuges that enrich uranium to bomb-grade level. One enrichment plant, called Fordow, is buried 250 feet beneath a mountain, where not even America's most powerful conventional weapon, a 30,000-pound bunker buster, can reach it. General James Cartwright, recently retired from the number two job in the U.S. military, said so just the other day during a panel discussion.
It's deep enough underground that there really aren't weapons to go down to penetrate that kind of activity.
But that does not mean Fordow is safe from attack. Its entrances could be sealed off, and that large rectangular building provides ventilation inside the mountain. But Admiral William Fallon, retired head of the U.S. Central Command, which would conduct a strike, says it's much more complicated.
There are a lot of targets. This is not a one-time shot. It's going to take a fair amount of work.
Israel is capable of a one-time strike, but only the U.S. has the air power to go back and hit targets again and again. Still, not even the U.S. could wipe out Iran's nuclear program.
Even if you could, again, you're not going to kill the intellectual capital to just rebuild the centrifuges someplace else and continue on.
Iran has plans to build 10 more enrichment plants, which is why Israel, with its relatively small air force, has said it cannot afford to wait much longer before it strikes.
The U.S. can afford to wait, but that would leave Israel entrusting its security to another country, something it has never done.
David, thanks very much.